Mr. Vitale, the pressure is on both teams in this third-round tournament game between the Marquette Golden Eagles and the Wisconsin Badgers. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Badgers looking at a very capable opponent tonight, Dick. What are their keys to victory, do you think?
If I'm on a bench, Brad, my keys would be simple. First of all, the point guard has to take control of the game, and he has to dictate the tempo and the pace. Second, make good decisions offensively and reduce those turnovers. Finally, play every defensive possession like it's the last.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Well, Dick, that didn't take very long.
I tell you, they're quick out of the game, baby.
He keeps his dribble as they reset.
The pressure's getting to him, Brad.
The shooting guard with the ball. Almost lost the basketball. From left of the circle, he shows the sweet touch. Down inside.
The frustration right there.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul there.
He's out of control, baby, out of control.
Puts it up, looking for contact. He puts it in with contact and all. They go into the low block.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. The center gets the pass. Here's the offensive drop step on the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Now trying to feed the low block. And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
Trying to feed the low block. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
The power forward takes the pass. In and out. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. And he'll kick it back outside. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Off the rim and no good. He launches a three, way off target. Gave it up.
Great anticipation defensively.
Looking for the foul. Goes in. Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
Looking to move it around the perimeter.
That's a high post screen, goes to the lane.
You betcha. Number 32 is pretty fired up and excited.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
The small forward takes the feed.
He allowed the screen to develop before he tossed in a nice inside basket.
Down in the low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
Off the rim and no good. Comes way out court and they'll have another chance. He tries the three ball. Way off target. Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
And off the mark. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Working it around the perimeter. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Looking for contact. Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. The center gets the ball. He fakes the shot. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin.
What a facial on that one. Number 45 going to the charity line for the first time tonight. Count it. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. That's a foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
With the free one. It's the first. And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. For two. They still don't score. Looking for a good shot. Picked out of the air. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up to get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
He bombs from outside. Off the rim and no good. Now they work it around the perimeter. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Dick are doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you what.
Makes the block. The ball goes out of play. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad and Dick, I'm down here by the losing team's bench. Their coaching staff is reminding them, look, it's just your nerves. Relax. It's only the first half. This team feels once they've settled in, they can take over here in the first half.
He missed on the steal. That's going to be the offense's game.
Yes, sir. They got the advantage right there once he misses that gamble.
The Badgers are beginning to get that additional exposure, especially with all the recent success in the postseason.
Hey, Brad, once you have this reputation, everything seems to fall into place. Recruiting becomes easier. The alumni starts to get involved. you appear on ESPN. Things just start to roll.
Picks off the lazy pass.
Team now, bad angle.
I think they're trying to make a statement. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleader as the mascot, everybody involved.
He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Gonna eliminate those turnovers.
I think he's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man. Up and inside.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional pass player.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense. Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
Looking for a good shot. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket. How about an instant replay?
On the outside, looks at a three. He misses it.
That was a great, great effort right there. Trying to play that passing lane. Anticipating really well. Dumping inside.
Takes away the pass. Way out on top with the block. There's a high screen. Has a nice look at the basket. Tries a three. Can't put it down. Jumped in front to take it away. Pushes it up. Leans in. Up and in. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
On the outside. Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us. Pushing that basketball.
Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Leaning in, trying to draw contact.
You got to let the offense play into the double.
Yeah, they may be forcing the double a little bit. And the jam. The crowd loves this young man.
The fans know exactly how much he has done for this program.
The Badgers will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on the post play. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
And the ball goes out of play. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
Hickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Wisconsin are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Step and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step, very slow. Gotta take some pride on a defensive end.
Unloads a three.
Great screen setup, but the shot won't go.
They get out on the break. Tries for two. And he scores despite the hack. And a momentary look from three-point land. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. But good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position.
He's got an open look for the shot. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. A defensive player beats him to the spot.
Way off target. Tries the turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
And a slam. Two for one opportunity. He unloads a three. That was nice. He's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Fake. Jumps in.
Got to make that, baby. Had that wide open angle. Had a chance to lay it on the glass for an easy deuce.
For two. Can't get the shot to drop. It off the rim and no good. At the end of the first half, the Badgers are up by four. Dick, what would you say is the play of the half in this tightly knit affair?
This one's big for me, Brad. The long trifecta. Shots like this can sometimes get a team going in a hurry.
All right, Dick, let's get back to the action as the two teams are just about ready to start the second half. Marquette seemed to have caught the turnover bug in that first half, Dick.
And that was big, and it bit them hard. You can't put points on a board if you turn the ball over. They better hope it doesn't come back to haunt them.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Off the lazy pass. Got a nice screen. Brings the shot. The Badgers lead by nine.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the three. Off the rim and no good.
Inside.
Moving it around the perimeter. Dumps it in. He beats him to the punch defensively and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Intercepted for the bucket. And he missed. like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
The shooting guard receives the ball. Number five, pump fakes. For two.
I love this guy, Hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting a good inside angle. A poor job defensively. No help. I mean, that is post play at its best. Look at that spacing.
Looking for a good shot. Looking for a good shot. Trying to draw the foul. Basket falls despite the contact. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Working it around the perimeter. The ball goes out of bounds. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
On the outside, top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. He forces another bad shot.
That is not how you win ball games, Mr. Nestler.
Way out on top, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They work it around the perimeter. Jumps into the defender. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
The center handles the feed. Rims out. He puts it in with contact and all.
Dump it inside.
He pump fakes. Looking for a screen on top and got it. You start comparing these backcourts, Dick. What are your impressions so far?
You know, well, for me, Brad, good guard play will take you a long ways. If you think about teams in the past, they all had good guards who can apply good ball pressure, attack off the dribble, and distribute the ball. I can't emphasize enough how important backcourt play is.
Moving it around the perimeter, in the paint. Trying to draw some contact. Too much contact there. It knocked him off balance a little. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Off the rim and no good.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Takes away the pass. The kick out. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Puts it up looking for contact. And he scores despite the hack. Steals the pass. Gave it up.
Spacing.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Number 32 is going to the charity stripe. He hits the first shot. Second one, good. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
He He makes a nice shot fake.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish a good tempo.
The center handles the pass. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I think a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Oh, my. He ran into a major league screen that time.
There's the screen up on top.
They'll work it around the arc. On the outside. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Perimeter with the jump hook. They still don't score. On the dribble, gives it up. Steals the ball. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Robs him of the ball. The perimeter in the paint. Number 22 makes a great move to draw the foul. Watch out, Dick. Their emotions seem to be getting the better of them. He is going to the line. First shot is no good. That. The Badgers are a frustrated bunch right now, I think.
Hey, they may be starting to sing the blues a bit. Emotionally, these guys are down. They better wake up.
Tries for two. And in and out. He intercepts it. Marquette was one of the nation's greatest between the late 60s and the 70s, and that was a time when the program was really flying.
Hey, great coach, great players, a few championships. It was a good era for the Warriors. Great job of freeing himself with the screen, but shot won't go.
Gave it up. The power forward receives the pass. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin?
Well, Brad and Dick, this is what people wanted to see, a close championship game. The action and intensity has really picked up down here, guys. Everyone wants to see a great finish.
He makes the first. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Sinks it. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad. Defense! Defense!
Defense! For two, he's going to pass those off, Nick.
He doesn't trust his teammates, Brad.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Picked off. Number 32. Modest play is having a negative effect on his composure. Emotionally, he couldn't be much lower on it.
Yeah, it's unfortunate to see this, Brad. I feel for him.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Penetrates and kicks back. He lets it go. Way off target. Great defense. Goes up for two. for the deuce. In and out. Tries for two. He drains the shot. The Badgers are ahead by eight. Time to pick up the defense here now. He's taken too many unnecessary shots, Nick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Rims out. On the dribble, gives it up. They move it into the front court. It's stolen. They get it out into transition. For the bucket. Easy one. Kicking back outside. Launches away. He gets that one to fall. Sets a screen for his teammate.
Great play to take that to the basket.
He does the sweet fake shot for two. Off the rim and no good. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He gives him the fake. He shoots from left of the circle. He hits the tough shot.
I'll tell you, he's knocking him down with ease, Brad.
He beats him to the punch. Here's the block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
He rejects it.
Dump it inside.
Pulls the trigger. And he can't hit the shot. The circle, they work it around the perimeter. For the deuce, rims out. That bucket counts and he'll go to the line.
Hey, excellent job there, drawing the foul and finishing the hoop.
He goes to the line, shooting one. Nothing but rim. He gets the rebound. Tries to turn and the defense comes. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Off the rim and no good. Dickie really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle and they also have the good entry from the wing.
Takes it off him. Gave it up. Fakes the shot. He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
Intercepted.
They're allowing no fast break baskets.
Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. Picks off the lazy pass. He shoots from left of the circle. Rims out. Timeout's been called. So let's check in with Aaron.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. I get a feeling they've changed things up a little bit, Dick.
We'll see what they come up with, Brad.
It's a three-point deficit.
And that can change in a matter of seconds, baby. Hold on.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Cross court. Jumped in front to take it away. Working it around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
It's no good. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Well, Dick, it looks like they're going to spend a little bit of time fouling right here. And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
Well, Dick, it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're getting good shots, and they're making them count. They're in a groove, baby. And when they're in a groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I'll tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
To the charity stripe. No doubt. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Rims out.
T.O. called. Hey, we got a barn burner here, baby. I'm thinking last second shot for the win, Mr. Nestler.
See who will benefit the most out of that timeout, Dick. And we're back to a two-point game.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing them to make that turn. They have to foul to put them on the line and hope they miss.
Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
Makes the front end of the 1-1. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
He makes the second.
They need to score here to turn this to a one-possession game.
They might try and surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
He shoots from half court. Dick, can they eventually get it going from behind the arc, you think?
If they stop forcing him, sure.
Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
Wisconsin makes it three in a row with an impressive third-round victory.
Hey, the way they're playing, Brad, this team is going to be hard to deal with entering the Elite Eight.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.